Hello YouTube, it's Delta0125 here again. I know I haven't been making videos recently, but that's due to me actually having a job at one point, and I got fired for that job, or from that job, for something that actually qualifies as wrongful termination. It's a little bit more discriminative in nature and involved and whatnot, and I'm seeking legal counsel and stuff, but that's another video for another time. But currently, I got some more first strike rations, as you can see, so I'm doing this in-depth review. Again, I apologize for not making too many videos, but like I said, I was working for a little while, and I'm debating on whether or not to release the footage that I have from the discrimination stuff. I still have to talk to my lawyer about that and stuff, so if he says go ahead to he or she, I don't know yet, but if they say to go ahead and release it, then I will. Otherwise, it's going to just stay with me until after the litigation's all done through and whatnot. Anyways, on the review here, got some first strike rations. I know I did a video a little while back, but I don't think I showed the outside of them. I think I just showed the box opened and then, like, showed, I think, the menus. And I don't remember if I opened one up or not, but I'm going to do a more in-depth review now, kind of like a little update video. But so on the review, first strike ration, obviously double banded, just like your MREs come. On the, let's see if I can flip this over real quick without knocking the camera over. Reverse side, it's got the SF, which does, by the way, stand for Special Forces. It is not something to do with the cardboard. At least that's what I've been told by the military guys that get these. So, and I actually live really close to Joint Base Elmendorf Richardson, which is Alaska's premier Army base and Air Force base. The next one that we have is Fort Wainwright, which is up in Fairbanks. Anyways, it says International Paper of Lancaster, guaranteed bursting test. On these, it's actually a little weirder because the MRE boxes say 550 pounds, whereas these ones only say 425 pounds. And then it's got like a little barcode thing here. I don't know what the hell that's about. Looks like it says 22 over here with a circle. No idea what that's about. I guess just for inventory. But these are official, as you can see. And then on the other side over here. Oh, on the other side from the first strike ration logo, it's just blank. Not that you probably care. And then on this one, it's got your date package lot. It says 2174, so 217th day on 2014, because every 10 years these go back to zero. So this one would be 2014, because first strike rations, I believe, came out in 2010 and were, see, 2009 were the prototypes for testing, I believe, and then 2008 and 2009, and then 2010, I believe, they actually were issued for once, and then they changed the packaging and stuff, and around 2012 they started replacing MREs from what I've seen. But you can still find MREs as good as 2016 being packaged. I believe they're still making the MREs, but these are what are ultimately going to be taking their place as far as I know. Inspection test is 614, but I think that's actually supposed to be the package lot, something to deal with that. Because the real inspection test date over here is 213th day of 2016. As you can see, it says 2136. And as you can see, the test dot thing, I forget what the hell it's called, but it's basically shows you if there's mold in there, if it's black or yellow or discolored. If it's not orange on dark red, then it's the stuff inside is likely spoiled. But, I mean, this is just kind of for the military, really, to show them, you know, whether or not the contents are spoiled in any way, shape, or form. But the thing is certain components may still be good, but if this is altered in any way, like yellow or black in the center, you know, or if it's torn for that matter, you should probably not trust the case of MREs or first strike rations in this case. However, like I said, this one's still good. It's a little inspection sticker, basically. So they can just do a little spot check on it when they pull the cases. They look, see if it's good. If it's good, put it back on the shelves or pull it. And I don't think you're, inside there's a little notice. Proc has been held under controlled temperature and humidity conditions and should not be considered overage because of date of pack, and the date of pack should not be the controlling factor in determining issuance utilization of the product. Again, like I said, the whoops, off the camera. There's a like I said, a little sticker thing. That's what they're talking about right here. Further refrigeration is not required. I apologize if I'm starting a little bit, but it is summertime up here and there's a lot of crap flying around. And currently I'm riding a bike, so yeah. And then as you can see here, here's your little NSN number for a strike ration. 9 meals, menu 1 to 3. That means there's 3 different menus in here and 3 meals of each menu type. And each, like there's 3, yeah, 3 meals that vary from one to the other, and then 3 bagged meals of each type. So you got 9 meals total, of course. And then weight, 29 pounds, which is actually an improvement because MRE cases are 35 pounds. I actually have one sitting over here off camera, which my Xbox One's sitting on. Then you have another, I guess, NSN code, which is a, I believe, Natick stock number. But anyways, Sapaco or Sapaco, however you want to pronounce it, is the ones that package these first strike rations. They're in Mullen, South Carolina, and then your little, I think that's their zip code, or zip area mailing, whatever code. Then, of course, you got the U.S. government property, commercial resales unlawful, blah, blah, blah. Which, what this means is if you try to open, like, a business and sell them, like, through the mail and stuff, it says it's unlawful. However, it's not illegal. Because it says unlawful, but, like I said, it's not illegal. They just frown upon it, really. That's what that means, and that's why eBay kind of had their little thing going on for a little while where they wouldn't sell them or let you sell MREs. But now eBay's letting you do that again. But commercial resale being unlawful, like I said, it doesn't say illegal, just unlawful. So you can actually resell these. It's just, like I said, frowned upon, especially if you're in the armed forces. And without further ado, let's just, whoops, bolt the camera again. Yeah, we'll open them right side up. So I'm going to open them on this side. This is supposed to be the top of them. There's letterings like that. I'm trying to do this with my camera pointing downwards. So, again, flip this over. It's only 29 pounds, but it is quite a bitch to do on the carpet. So, got my little field bayonet here. I believe this is an M7 model. It doesn't have the little ring for the M16. So, oops. There we go. And I'll just pull those aside. So just throw those out here in a minute. Use this sort of like a. I've actually discovered that flathead screwdriver does this just as well. So, yeah, this actually appears to be the bottom of the box. Move on. Just flip it around. See if I can get the trench knife up underneath there. There we go. Yep, this appears to be possibly the bottom. Another design feature that I noticed is that these come in clear bags, and the MREs are in tan bags. So, these up. And my last batch of first strike rations, my last video, I think I did a video on them. If you've seen that video, those were $90 for the case, and these ones I found actually locally for $75 for the case at a different place. However, the one place that I bought them for $90 is still selling them at $90, which is a 907 Surplus up here in Anchorage, Alaska. If you guys are interested, go check them out. They actually have a Facebook page, too. Ooh, almost got paper cut from the cardboard. So, put this up real quick. Put that up. Put that over there. Put the chair. And this is how they come packed. Case, and as you can see, we got two of the tuna menus. Like I said, there's three menus of each. So we got a first strike ration, 24-hour ration. Like I said, the bags are clear. This first one has the honey barbecue beef sandwich, which isn't actually that bad. Pound cake, plain cheese spread, beverage, it says there's two of them here. First strike energy bar, cran raspberry, which is just a hoorah bar from the MREs. Got beef ravioli, not beef ravioli, it says beef snack, teriyaki flavor. And then you got zapple sauce, mayonnaise, caffeine gum, which is actually a cinnamon flavored first strike gum. I actually prefer the Meg MEG military energized gum, which I bought off of Amazon, which is a peppermint flavor, because I don't like cinnamon flavor. I haven't tried them yet, but that's because they have 100 milligrams caffeine and I don't feel like staying up for a day. So let's see, resealable plastic bag. Then you got tuna, tortillas, crackers, first strike energy bar, mocha flavor. You got dessert bar, chocolate banana, whatever the hell that is. Oh, that's probably a hoorah bar. And you got your beef snack, barbecue flavor. Those ones actually taste like a really like mild, dull, like a Slim Jim, I want to say. Like if you ever had a barbecue flavored Slim Jim, that's about what those taste like or remind me of. So it's really not all that great, but I mean it's still, you know, a beef stick. So you got your nut fruit mix, accessory packet A, which is pretty much the same crap as always. Hand cleaner, you got two of those, which is probably just wet naps. And you got a spoon, so that's what you get in this one. It's got a Starkist Albacore, which I'm actually quite a fan of, to be honest. The sandwiches are by Bridgeford. I've actually had, I've actually gotten these from Cabela's, and I believe they're on Cabela's.com as well. I had some laying around, but I ate them. I just kind of eat them when we're low on groceries in the house. I don't feel like going to the store, so that's your menu one. Which one is this? Like I said, there's three menus in here. This one here is, so I believe this is the menu three. One was this, menu three? Yep, menu three. So this is the same one. All three of these are the same, so I'm gonna pull them out. Then you've got, let's see, it's menu two. Yep, menu two, which has the Italian style sandwich, which by the way tastes like a, if you've ever had the Chef Boyardee jumbo meatballs, it's kind of like a somewhat spicier version of that. Not really spicy, but spices in like spaghetti spice. If you've had the MRE spaghetti with meat sauce, it's like that being shoved into a Bridgeford sandwich. Like really, I don't know, like, honestly I'm not a fan of their bread, but it's not exactly crappy because you can eat it, but it takes some getting used to, I'll put it that way. It's not something you want seconds of really, but you can still eat it. But yeah, that's basically what it tastes like. And sometimes you get like a little fingernail, like a pinky nail sized, pinky nails right now because I trim my nails, but you get like a pinky nail sized kind of piece of onion in it sometimes, which doesn't taste all that good, obviously. But looks like there's some chicken in here. But yeah, there's toaster pastry, peanut butter, beverage, there's two of them. First strike energy bar, cran raspberry, beef sticks. There's actually beef snacks in each one of these. Zapple sauce, mayonnaise, caffeinated gum. That's where it says caffeinated gum on this one. Oh, that's right. The caffeinated mints are probably those challenge mints. I actually have some up here in the drawer. Hand cleaner, two of them, and then spoon. And then you get chicken, tortillas, crackers, your first strike energy bar, apple cranberry, which, like I said, that's apple cinnamon, not cranberry, it's apple cinnamon, which is, again, I mean, It's pretty much just a power bar. And then dessert bar mocha, your beef snack barbecue, nut fruit mix, accessory packet B, hot sauce, and a resealable closable plastic bag, which is pretty much what you would put your contents from this bag in. Like, because the reason why we did that was most soldiers were actually field stripping their MREs and just leaving components all over the place. So instead, they give you a little bag to reseal. And let me get some of those mints real quick. Yes, I have some right here, as a matter of fact. There's two different kinds, actually, I've gotten out of MREs, and I believe these come in the first strike rations, too. They both look like this. They're either challenge mints or they're cool caffeine mints. But the thing about these mints are you take, as you can see here, 10 mints equal 1 cup of coffee, whereas 5 mints equal 1 cup of tea, 4 mints equal 1 can of soda, so they're not all that powerful. And then the challenge mints are pretty much the same thing. And like I said, I mean, those are pretty much really just complete crap. Thing that I prefer is this here, military energy gum. As you can see, it has 100 milligrams of caffeine per piece, and there's like 5 pieces in each of these. So if you need to be up and alert and stuff, that's just a more viable option. I believe this one down here may be menu 1. Nope, that is a menu 2. One of these has to be menu 1 over here. Yes, menu 1. So here you got filled French toast, which, by the way, that stuff tastes like shit. I'm not even gonna lie, straight up, like, I mean, not that I've ever tasted shit, but I can just guess. This is probably like the nastiest diarrhea you've ever smelt in a public bathroom, like aftertaste in the back of your throat kind of taste, probably. So I would not recommend that filled French toast. I'd recommend just throwing it out or giving it away or something. That stuff just tastes like crap. It's just like their first strike cinnamon buns. Same thing. Tastes exactly the same as a filled French toast. It tastes like almost like raw, uncooked eggs, if you will. And then it's honestly not that good. It's like that, but like eggs have been left on the counter for like a day or two. But anyways, the pepperoni sandwich is actually pretty decent. It's got it's like not really spicy, but it's Bridgeford pepperoni. If you've ever gone to Walmart and gotten their sliced pepperoni, it's basically that shoved in their first strike ration bread, which, like I said, takes a while to get used to. But it's honestly pretty decent. Like I said, it's nothing you'd want seconds of. The only one I've ever actually wanted seconds of was when I was hungry as all hell, and I had the Bridgeford barbecue beef sandwiches. But they got wheat snack bread, which is actually really good once you get used to it. It's just really dry as all, so, you know, have some water handy or something, even though you don't really need to. It's just something that I would have handy, like a water bottle or a can of soda or a bottle of soda. You know, just something to drink with that, because that stuff is really dry. And then, let's see here, First Strike Energy Bar, mocha flavor. Dessert Bar Peanut Butter, which is a peanut butter power bar. You got Beef Snack Barbecue Flavor, Nut Fruit Mix, Caffeine Gum, which is probably, well, that stuff, like I said, is the First Strike Gum. I've actually got some that I forgot to show. Get those here in a minute. Hand cleaner, and then a spoon. Over here you got your bacon cheddar sandwich, which my friend Richard that moved out to his village, or moved back to his village, I should say, he actually said that those are really good, although they're, you know, a First Strike sandwich, so they're not the best. The thing with these First Strike sandwiches is they try to make them like Hot Pockets, but they're not as tasty as a Hot Pocket. But this one has different bread. It's got cheddar-flavored bread. It reminds me of the Italian, like, cheddar bread from Subway's. When you look at it, it's like that with cheddar and ham inside of the sandwich for the filling. You get your jalapeno cheddar spread, your beverages, First Strike bar, chocolate, actually, for this one. And you've got your beef snack teriyaki. That's weird, I don't see. Oh, there it is, beef snack barbecue on this side. Went over that, apparently. It's applesauce, accessory packet C, which isn't really that much different. Hot sauce, and then your reclosable bag. So all that stuff is like this, in this bag. These are actually really good for going out camping, hiking, hunting, anywhere that you're going to be out for a little while. So that's why I pick these up whenever I can find them, because they're 24. These are actually a true 24-hour ration. I would not have a problem taking these out in the middle of nowhere with me. Let's see, what the hell is that? Find the oh, I got it in my hand. That is. That's right. That's what their chicken is, a Sweet Sue premium chicken breast, just like you can find at Walmart. It's 98% fat-free, which that's actually a death sentence if you're out in the wilderness and you're really cold, being fat-free, because the fat will actually keep you warm, believe it or not. And it says taste the difference, which is just because it's a healthy meal. But honestly, I could give a damn less about healthy meals. I mean, hell, I'm not really even that heavy, so. But again, that's just a little insight into these first strike rations. And here in a minute, I'm going to open one of these mini threes just to give you an idea of what I've been talking about. And let's see if I can find one real quick. Ah, here it is. This is the caffeine gum they're talking about. These actually came out of my last first strike rations. But they're cinnamon flavor, and like I said, I don't care for cinnamon flavor, but these are the exact same thing. Pretty much, they have 100 milligrams of caffeine per piece, but they're cinnamon flavor, so I don't care for cinnamon. Like I said, that's why I got the mint flavor. And that's pretty much what I got over here. But as far as these rations go, I'm going to go ahead and just empty one out on the top here. I got little easy open parts at the top, so you can actually rip these open now. Whereas old MRE bags, you had to fight to open. So these ones you just pull apart real quick. But they're still about as tough as an MRE bag. They're just a little bit less tough. So here's your open first strike ration. That little bag that you see right here is your bag for your leftovers and stuff. Anything you don't eat is supposed to go into this brown bag, which I have a few of from the last first strike rations I had. It's just a simple little open zip close bag, like a little Ziploc. It's about a gallon and a half, I want to say. It's a little bit bigger than your storage bags by Ziploc. I have no idea who they contracted out for these, but they're actually pretty durable plastic, almost like the... It's almost the same consistency of these first strike bags, but it's a little bit less thick. So, I don't know what they're thinking was those. These here are your beef sticks. You have both in here, your teriyaki and your barbecue flavor. And show you what these look like. That bag actually smells pretty good. It smells like a barbecue. You got your Bull's jerky here. Now, the thing that sucks when they package them like this is you cannot tell generally which one is teriyaki and which one is the barbecue, but in general, the bigger one is going to be the barbecue flavor, which, like I said, is like a really salty, oily kind of almost like a Slim Jim barbecue flavor, whereas the teriyaki is more of like a really juicy, kind of a chunky... not really chunky flavor, but chunky meat. Both these have chunky meat in, but this one's a little bit drier. This one's a little bit less dry. But the teriyaki tastes about like if you've ever had Tillamook brand teriyaki sticks. Or not sticks, but teriyaki, well, yeah, I guess sticks, but they're like the flat slab sticks. It's basically the same thing as this, but this one tastes more like a Slim Jim for some odd reason. The way that you can tell is flip these over, and a lighter one is the teriyaki in general, and the darker one is always going to be the barbecue flavor. So, and like I said, the barbecue one's generally a little bigger because it tastes like crap, so they gave you more for it. And the teriyaki one tastes better, so they gave you a little bit less. I don't know why that is. I'd rather have that reversed, honestly. But, like I said, these are the beef sticks. I'm putting them over here so the dog don't eat them. He's laying over here on the bed behind me. And you can smell them. That's why the white guy's ears perked up. Here are your tortillas. Which are just standard little tortillas. If you want to see a review of these, someone that does a really good review on these is theepicenter.com. My foot just slid across the floor behind me. So, yeah, theepicenter.com, they actually have a really good review on most MREs and stuff. I don't know why, but people have been buying up the pork rib, even though it's making a comeback. But that's because the Natick Center, I guess, was talking about discontinuing it or something. So people have been buying it up, but now it's making a comeback. But theepicenter.com does a really good review on tortillas and stuff. And they actually review, like, the entrees for MREs, which they sell on their site. And you got crackers here. Racist bastards. Kidding. You got your spoon. Standard MRE-type spoon, which you don't really need except for the tuna and stuff like that. You got your accessory packet. I believe this is accessory packet A with the coffee in it. And you got your mayonnaise over here for mixing with your tuna. Got iodized salt, your little Chiclets gum in there. That's not a laxative gum. That's just regular gum to, you know, quell anyone's little fears or anything. That's actually just Chiclets, the same thing you would buy at the store. It's just bigger as all, because they figured, you know, why put a bunch of little miscolored Chiclets in there and stuff, like different colored ones and whatnot. Instead, they just put in two, and if it's clear like this, it's going to be a mint flavor. If it's got a red backing or something like that, it's going to be a cinnamon-flavored type Chiclets. But they got your salt, your sugar, your wet naps and stuff all up in here. And then your gum is actually in here, too. So there's a cinnamon-flavored gum in there. You can tell because it's like a reddish, dark reddish color. You got your toilet paper or a napkin, however you want to use that. And then, let's see, that would be the mayonnaise. And I think that's about it for the accessory packet. What is that? Oh, that's just the other side there. Napkin. Got your nut fruit mix. This one happens to have sunflower kernels in it and infused fruit, which is basically just... I don't know why the hell they call it infused fruit. It honestly is like a freeze-dried kind of fruit, really. But 56 grams nut fruit mix. This is actually pretty decent. It's got 310 calories per packet. And calories from fat is 220. I don't know how in the hell you got fat inside of trail mix, maybe from the nuts. But for 56 grams, 310 calories is actually pretty good. The sugars are 6 grams, carbohydrates 17. Not that anyone really cares. Just thought I'd list that stuff. It's not really that much in there. And you got your lemon-lime flavored fruit juice, which is actually the same thing you can buy at Walmart in the tubs. This is basically just powdered Gatorade. That's all this is. But, I mean, it really doesn't taste all that great. And, of course, you could just throw the sugar in it, I guess. Oh, we got a lemon poppy seed pound cake. This is actually very, very good. I might actually try to hang on to this instead of eat it. Got your lemon, or your grape flavored Powerade as well, or not Powerade, but a Gatorade. So you got grape and you got lemon lime. And you got your Bridgeford sandwich with honey barbecue beef in it, which again is the same thing that you can find at Cabela's for, I believe it's $6 up here locally, but again we don't pay sales tax and we have to have stuff shipped up here. So you can find these two packs for $6 at our local Cabela's, no sales tax if you ever come up here on a hunting trip or whatever. This is applesauce. This is one thing that I have never found on any shelf. This is specific to the First Strike rations. It's called Zapplesauce. It's enhanced maltodextrin for increased performance, which I looked that stuff up and it's basically artificial sugar. I want to say Splenda, but Splenda's a fake sugar, whereas this is a real sugar. But the calories, let's see, what the hell? Yeah, I don't think that's proper calories. Oh, okay, yeah, daily value. So 65 grams of calories or 80 grams, something like that. Maybe that's just the I think that might be the chart for the daily value stuff or whatever your daily value is supposed to be. First Strike mocha flavored energy bar. This one, this is going to be the peanut butter bar. Peanut butter dessert bar. This one's actually a smash down. Like I said, it's just power bar. That's all these really are. It's just power bars and cliff bars and that sort of thing. Got another First Strike bar here. Cran raspberry flavor. And then you have your Starkist albacore white tuna. So this is actually pretty good. I mean, it's all white meat. There's no black little chunks in it or anything from, you know, like any of the other, like, tunas that you've ever eaten. But, I mean, this stuff can be found on Walmart shelves in the, I believe it's in the canned meats aisle. It might be in the, gotta forget the aisle, the soup aisle, I want to say. But this stuff is actually pretty good. I'm going to go ahead and open this up before I end the video, because I'm going to go ahead and eat this tonight, since I just opened the whole packet. But, the Bridgeford sandwiches are actually pretty decent. If I can get the damn thing open. Just don't want to open at that point, apparently. I like how they package these with the, for the most part, easy care sides. Because they're open at the bottom there. Ah, there we go. Got it open at the bottom. And then these just come out looking like this. They're not too appetizing to look at. You got your little. You just drop a piece of bread. You got your little fresh do not eat packets in here, the silica gel packets. So it doesn't really smell too appetizing, but you can smell the barbecue inside. And when you take a little piece off, I mean, it takes a little while to get into the sandwich. That's mostly all bread right there. It doesn't taste all that great. But as you can see, it starts opening up into filling. And when you're out in the wilderness and whatnot, these are actually pretty good when you don't have anything else to eat. So, and then, like, you open up like that, there's actually, I just dropped a little piece of meat somewhere. Oh well, dogs will get it. So there's actually a little bit of chunky meat, which actually goes all the way across. So, peel this back. As you can see, it goes pretty much almost all the way across the sandwich. And that's a pretty good sized chunk of meat right there. So these are actually very good for the for the price at Cabela's, because they're almost like eating a Hot Pocket out in the middle of nowhere. I'm trying to eat this bread right now. It's it's not really a bad bread. It's just nothing you'd really want seconds of, but the filling is what you're after. But yeah, I mean, they're not that bad. I mean, 2 for $6 isn't all that bad when it's, they got 400 calories a piece. Well, sometimes they're dry, sometimes they're wet on the inside a little bit for as far as the sauce goes. This one seems a little bit dry, but it's nothing too bad. Still gonna eat it. This one particularly has only 290 calories for this one, but for some odd reason, the ones at Cabela's are 400 calories, but they're probably stuffed with more meat than this one is, because this one was made for, you know, special forces and the like. So, but then again, I don't know why they, you know, pack those ones full of meat, not these ones. But Bridgeford has actually come out with more menu options and stuff, which are also available at theepicenter.com, so I check out their YouTube page. I believe it's The Epicenter, if you type that in above in the search bar somewhere. And then theepicenter.com is their actual website. I've actually dealt with them on the phone and stuff, and they're actually pretty nice. They can actually fill your order over the phone if you would prefer, instead of just adding things to your cart and then doing it that way. But, yeah, like I said, I mean, for the most part, these are worth the money, as far as I can see, especially over MREs, because you get 9 24-hour rations, which is 9 days worth of food, compared to MREs, which is 12 meals per case, but you have to eat at least 3 meals per day. You can get by with one or two, but I mean, that's if you wanted to stretch it, but you're supposed to eat around 3 meals per day for your caloric intake, if you will, which is the calories you're supposed to eat per day. And if you do the math on that, that's about 3 to 4 days worth of food, depending on, you know, how you eat them. Maybe up to 6 days worth of food if you stretch it. And if you really stretch it, you can get 12 days, but I wouldn't stretch it that far unless you were actually in survival mode. These, however, are 9 straight days of food. I mean, each one of these 24-hour rations packs around 2,400 to, I believe it's 3,200 calories per 24-hour ration. So you can actually get by with these, just one per day. Whether you're out camping, hiking, hunting, you know, fishing, doing whatever, which is why I buy them mainly. I'm going to keep the other 8 in here for because I haven't really run across these boxes too much at the surplus stores. I actually have to talk to my Special Forces friends to get a hold of some of these boxes sometimes. And I can't help but eat everything that's in them most of the time, or most of the stuff that's in them. But if I'm not being picky, I'll, you know, eat everything in them. So again, these are really good for the money. This case I bought for $75. You can find them anywhere from about $50 on upwards of $200 if you look around online. Most of the times you'll find them on eBay, but they'll be individual meals. But if you look at surplus stores near military bases and things like that, you might find a case of these, and I would suggest picking them up. But if you're a hoarder, come on guys, just don't hoard the shit out of them. I mean, you know, let other people have at them. I mean, if that's your whole thing where you're like, oh, fuck everyone else, well, I guess that's on you, but I'm just saying, don't be a dick. Because these are actually really good, especially if you're not the type that goes out, you know, camping and hiking and hunting, that sort of thing. Quit hoarding MREs in the first strike ration. There's no reason to. You know, there's not going to be some revolution or any crap like that that I can foresee. The only thing I see in a city scenario of, like, a metropolis or something is, like, civil unrest from, like, a riot or something, you know, something like Ferguson, maybe. But other than that, or maybe the LA riots, but if you're not in a high crime area or anything like that, then, you know, I mean, don't really speculate on hoarding these unless you got, like, maybe a cabin somewhere, I want to say. Then you hoard them, you know, or if you're in, like, a disaster-prone area, go for it. But, you know, like I said, just try not to be a dick, like everyone was with the 22 ammo, which is just now coming back on the shelves up here. But, again, 24-hour ration, pretty good. You get 9 meals, which is 9 days worth of food out of this for one person, or 3 days for 3 people out of this. So, again, I mean, I really recommend them if you can find them. Hard to come by. Price is iffy, depending on where you get them from. But if you can find these, or even cold weather rations, which take water because they're Mountain House, basically just rebranded in military stuff, or standard MREs, you know, I'd recommend picking them up. But, you know, just know what you're getting. You know, taste test stuff, if you will, you know, which is a great place to do that at, is the epicenter.com. Just order one of every single menu, if you can afford it, or every single item. I mean, some items they only have in 12 packs, like the sides and things, but most of the sides and stuff are good. So, yeah, like I said, epicenter.com, check them out. Check out their YouTube page. And other than that, this is the pretty much unboxing and semi-review of the First Strike ration. And the funny thing is if you don't want your First Strike ration sandwich, your dog may actually eat it, believe it or not. Unlike the veggie omelet MRE that everyone hated that they finally got rid of. So, yeah. I wish someone would come back with the original grilled beef patties. Those were actually pretty good for the MREs. Original chicken breast is still around. The barbecued pork ribs are still around. They're still making those, so you know you can quit hoarding them if you're a hoarder. Let's see, what was another one? Spaghetti with meat sauce is still in all the MREs, as far as I know. They came out with a buffalo chicken one, which I haven't tried, but I guess that'll be another video for another day. And I'm gonna go and throw that away real quick. So again, I mean, if you got any Special Forces friends that can get a hold of these, or any military friends that can get a hold of these for that matter. They can order them from either the Field Chef, I think, or maybe the BX Base Exchange. Hate going on base because they charge tax every single base that I've been to for some odd reason. Even up here, Anchorage, Alaska, we have no sales tax. You go on base, they have sales tax. I have no idea why that is. And even then, your military friend has to buy them for you. But other than that, you know, it's just the whole crap of getting on base, you know, got to sign papers and stuff to even get a pass and have your military friend vouch for you and support you and all that stuff. And then you go through a little half-hour interview, and then you're pretty much allowed to go on base and whatnot. So, but yeah, if you can get them, go ahead and get them. And this has been Delta-0125, been rambling on for too long. I'm going to go ahead and end this video and eat, I guess, the rest of this first strike ration. We'll see you guys later, and that's pretty much what I've been up to. Next video will be here on the 4th or 5th, whenever I upload it. But on the 4th, I'm going out to the NR Youth Day again. If anyone on my YouTube channel goes to NR Youth Day, I will be at the machine gun booth, I believe on range G, if we're doing the same range again this year. If not, just look for us down there. You can hear us from the machine gun fire and a tannerite going off. And I will likely be in the city camo yet again. So, it's been Delta-0125, signing out.